Today we are going to start our next chapter, chapter 11, the prepositions. Although students, this topic is not a new one for you. This topic you have already done in your previous classes. Let's recapitulate. Might be we will learn something new. So students, look at these sentences which are written here. He lives in Chandigarh. Varanasi is on the Ganga River. Students, these are complete sentences and meaningful also. That's why they are called sentences, because they are meaningful. Now forget these prepositions for a while. He lives Chandigarh. Varanasi is the Ganga River. Does it make any sense? Of course, no. So what comes the definition of preposition? Beta, a preposition thus can be defined as a word or group of words. Means any preposition can be there. In, on, out of, from, under, since, any preposition can be there. Used before a noun or pronoun, or sometimes a gerund also, to show its relation with the another words of the sentence. Now in this class, which are in this tutorial, we are going to learn about the definition of preposition and different aspects also. Which are those aspects? Prepositions definition, preposition of time, preposition of place, preposition of position, and preposition of motion and direction. Now let's discuss in detail. Let's learn the chapter.
So students, here we have our chapter number 11 of grammar, the prepositions. Beta, read the following sentences. I meet Ram at 8 o'clock. She died in 1999. There is a book on the table. So, the words at, in, on in the above sentences are called preposition. And what is the definition? A preposition thus can be defined as a word or group of words used before a noun, pronoun, or gerund to show its relation to another words in the sentence. And as I told you in the beginning also, there are certainly different aspects, different usage of prepositions. So let's start with our first type, which is preposition of time. First of all, let's understand at, on, in form of preposition of time, how these are used. Obviously, these prepositions are used to show the time and date of events, activities, and situations. At is used for a point of time, means at plus particular time, like dawn, midday, noon, night, midnight, 5 o'clock, etc. And here are the examples also. I met him at 11:40 o'clock. At plus particular time. She returned at noon. They started at dawn. So these are the examples of at, which shows particular time in the sentence. Further, we have at plus the plus a particular time in a week, month, or year. We are going there at the end of the week. She left school at start of the month. So in this way also, at is used in sentence. At plus festival. They had a holiday at Diwali. He visited his friend at Christmas. At is also used with meal, like they met each other at dinner. All the friends were present at lunch. So these are the uses of at. Next is on. On is used for day, date, etc. On plus day of week like Monday, Tuesday, Friday, any day can be there. The party started on Monday. The meeting took place on Thursday. So in this way, on is used with day or date. On plus particular part of a day. Friday morning, Thursday evening, and so on. So they reached Shillong on Sunday afternoon. Obviously, on plus particular part of a day. On plus particular date. This is the most common sentence. She was born on 10th December 2001. He returned from Ludhiana on 8th June. You students also, whenever you tell someone your birthday, then you also use on in the same way. Next we have on plus festival day. Earlier we used only Diwali or Christmas, but here we are using day along with the festival. So in this way, on is used with festival day. She was here on Diwali day. They came here on Christmas day. Next we have in. In is generally used for a period of time to show time frame or period of time. In the plus part of a day, in the morning, in the evening, in the afternoon. I go for a walk in the morning. She went to market in the evening. In plus month or year also. His father died in January. My sister was born in 1988. Further, the use of in is again there. In plus season of the year, a specific century, in summer, in winter, in 20th century, etc. He goes to Shimla in summer. India got freedom in the 20th century. So in is used with particular season of the year, specific century, etc. In is also used in plus historical period of time, in the Middle Ages, in the Dark Ages, in the prehistoric times, etc. Religion was a great force in England in the Middle Ages. So with historical period of time also in is used. In is also used with the length of time. When we say in 10 minutes or in 3 months, in 6 years, etc., there also in is used. I covered the distance in 20 minutes. So here in is used, in preposition will be used. Next we have the same use of in, the same use of the same preposition, show future time reference, time starting from now. I'll be back in 2 hours. The time will start now only, and within 2 hours I'll come back. So I'll be back in 2 hours. Show future time reference, time starting from now. There also in is used. Next we have for and since, and these prepositions we have used many a times. Can you guess the students where? Obviously in perfect progressive tense we have used many a times for and since. So for is used for a period of time and since for a point of time. For and since indicate how long an event, activity or situation has continued. How? Let's understand. He has lived here for 2 years. It is a period of time, that's why for is used. I have not met him since morning. It means there is a point of time. That's why since has been used here. So always remember students, if there is period of time, then for is used. If point of time, then since is used. Next we have during. Students, during is used to express an idea that occurs throughout the whole specified period, like during the war, during the 18th century, during the last week, etc. She received many messages during the last week. A specific point, but it goes on for the throughout whole specified period. There was shortage of food when during the war, means in that whole period, in that whole specified period, there was a shortage of food. Further, we have the use of by. By is used to indicate the latest time by which something was or is to be done. Many a times we also use this preposition in our sentence. Okay, we will complete this chapter by Thursday. We will complete this chapter number 11 by Saturday. So by is used to indicate the latest time by which something was or is to be done. You must return by 8 p.m. He should finish this lesson by Tuesday. Obviously, it is used to the latest time by which something will be done. Next, we have before, after, the easiest prepositions. Before is used for something to be done before a specific time. After suggests that something will be done after a particular time. Ma'am, I will submit my notebook before third period. Ma'am, I will come to school after 2 days as I am not well, or I have to go somewhere. Many a time, students, you also use this preposition in your daily conversation. So let's understand through the examples. You must reach school before 8 a.m. means before a specified time. You cannot enter the class after 8 a.m. Obviously, that something will be done after a particular time. So this after preposition is used. Next, we have till and until. These prepositions describe a time limit for the commencement or completion of an activity. Commencement or completion, either time limit in which something will be completed. You should wait till, until. Till or until both can be used here. Friday, the streets are crowded from morning till night, means this is the last point and the completion of action will be there. So there we use till and till or until. So students, till now we have come to know about prepositions of time. Now we are going to understand preposition of place. Students, at, on, and in as prepositions of place which show the position of people, place, and things. At indicates a point, on a line or surface. In indicates an area or volume. Now let's start with at. At plus the plus place. Always take care, students, that whenever you are using at in terms of place, then at plus the plus that specific place will be mentioned, like cinema, theater, school, cross road, etc. So the formation would be: she was at the theater, I was at school, he stood at the crossroads. Next we have at plus specific place: at the Grand Hotel, at Dum Dum Airport, at New Delhi Railway Station, etc. Examples: the plane landed at Heathrow Airport, I stayed at the Grand Hotel. So in this way, at plus specific place, at plus the plus place, in this way this preposition will be used. Further, we have at plus specific address. At 9 Model Town, at 10 Downing Street. He lives at 7 Model Town. The Prime Minister of England lives at 10 Downing Street. So with specific address we use at. Next preposition on, in terms of place how it will be used. On indicates a line or surface in sphere. The place is thought of in terms of length but not breadth or depth. The book is on the table. There is a picture on the wall. Next we have on plus parts of the body. On the foot, on our heads, on her left arm, etc. She has been on her foot all day. He put the bundle on his head. So with parts of body also we use on. Next we have on is used with types of transport. Like he rode on the horse. She was on the train to Delhi. On is used with transports also. We also use on when we talk about a place as a line. Varanasi is on the Ganga River. Obviously, it's a place as a line. So, Varanasi is on the Ganga River. The house is on the main road. So, when a place is mentioned as a line, then also we use on. Next preposition we have in. How do we use in as a preposition of place? In indicates area, usually ground or place enclosed by boundaries and volume, that is thought of in term of length, breadth and height. How? Let's understand through examples. In plus name of countries, towns, cities. He lives in India. She has lived in England. So, an area that indicates or which is enclosed by boundaries, with them also in preposition is used. Next we have in plus residence or houses. In a bungalow, in a palace, in a flat, etc. I would like to live in a bungalow. So, with residence also, in terms of residence also, in is used. Students, when we want to talk about our place work, then also we use in preposition, like in a bank or in a factory or in a firm. My father works in a bank, my neighbor works in a bank, his father works in a bank, or any example can be there. So when we want to describe our workplace, then also we use in preposition. In is also used with rooms and places. Like any place can be there, in the kitchen, in the room, in the bathroom, etc. She has been in the kitchen for half an hour. So for rooms and places also in preposition is used. On the basis of the understanding till now, students, you can easily attempt exercise 1 and 2. Further, we have students, preposition of position means what is the position of an object. Prepositions of position show a relation between two objects. They can be explained by means of pictures, how above, over, below, under, underneath. Let's discuss about these first of all. Above and below mean that one thing is in the higher or lower position than other. Underneath often means that one object is actually touching the other. In this respect, it is the opposite of on top of. Over and under indicate a direct vertical relationship or nearness. Like above, let's see the example of above. Raise your hands above your head. One thing, in a higher position than the other. So above, this example can be understood. Raise your hands above your head. Or if we want to use below, then we can see this example. Fish were swimming below the water. Always remember, students, that the plural of fish is fish only, not es. You will be adding fishes by writing. So fish were swimming below the water. Here we can see, students, the examples and the pictures underneath. What's underneath the mat? As I have already told you, underneath often means that one object is actually touching the other. In this respect, it is the opposite of on top of. So here you can see that this preposition underneath has been described here so nicely, because one object is touching another. Over, there is a cat over the box, because over and under indicate a direct vertical relationship or nearness. Same as under, there is a cat under the table. Here also vertical connection is there, vertical relationship is there. So in this way, above, below, underneath, over and under preposition can be used. Further, we have other prepositions, by and beside. By and beside both mean at the side of, but there is a difference. By generally means near to somebody, and beside generally means exactly next to somebody or something. Beside, near to somebody or something. Beside means exactly next to somebody or something. There is a house by the river, means near the river. The child sat beside his sister, means next to his sister. Further, we have in front of and behind. We all know in front of, which is in front of us, in front of our vision. The boy was in front of the car and the girl was behind the car. Next, between and among. Between relates an object or to other objects, and among relates it to more than two objects. If I say the house stands between two streets, here we are talking about two objects, but the house stands among trees means more than two objects are there. So between is used for two other objects, and among relates it to more than two objects. Next, we have against. Here is the perfect picture to understand against. Against means close to, touching or striking something. The ladder stood against the wall. We have to use against when something is closing, when something is close to something, some other thing, or it is touching or striking something, then against is used. Proceed and understand preposition of motion and direction. Students, motion and direction, the name itself is making the meaning clear. Let's understand from and to first. Something which is in moving condition. In this way, preposition of motion and direction are used. So from and to. This bus is from Delhi to Jaipur, or any other example can be there. From is used with the point of departure and to is the end point of destination. He went from Delhi to Patna. Next, off. Off has the meaning from the surface of and also down from. She took the pot off the table. He fell off his horse. Definitely, it has the connection from surface and also from. from the surface of and also down from. Next we have into, out of. Into means moving aside a place seen as a volume, and out of means moving outside. The boy ran into the classroom. She came out of the room. In moving condition, we use these prepositions. Over indicates movement from one side of something to the other. The boy jumped over the wall. In motions, in movement, he jumped over the wall. Towards means in the direction of somebody or something. He walked towards the river, means he went towards the river. Along indicates movement from one end towards the other end of something. How? And the place is always seen in a line. They walked along the street. Means simultaneously both are going together. So they walked along the street. It indicates movement from one end towards the other end of something. The place is seen as a line. Next we have across. Across indicates movement from one side of a space, area or line to the other side. Like here it is given. The goat walked across the river, means from one side to another side. That means across is used. Next we have onto. Onto means moving to a position on the surface. The cat jumped onto the table, means onto, moving to a position on the surface. Next we have up, down. We all know about this preposition. Up indicates movement to a higher position somewhere. Down indicates movement from a higher point to a lower one. The girl ran up the stairs. The boy ran down the stairs. Obviously up and down. Up means going further, going to a higher position or somewhere, and down means a higher point to a lower one. Next we have through. Through indicates movement from one side to an opening or a passage to the other. The place is seen as volume. The train went through the tunnel, means the train has crossed that area. Through indicates movement from one side of an opening or passage to the another one, and of course the place is a wider one also. So students, this was all about the explanation of preposition, but still there are some points which I want to discuss with you. Now look at the screen carefully and understand different usage of at and to. Look at the difference in the meaning of these prepositions when they follow certain verbs. Mohan threw a stone to me. Mohan threw a stone at me. To me, a friendly action, or and at means an unfriendly action, means he intended to hurt his friend. So at is used for unfriendly action and to is used for friendly action. Seema ran to me. Again the same thing, a friendly action, and ran at me just to attack me or hit me. She ran to me, Seema ran to me. So at me shows an unfriendly action. Ramesh shouted at me. Now students, I have explained these two examples, and obviously you can understand the next one, that Ramesh shouted to me. in a friendly way, but shouted at me, intended to express his anger. He pointed to me, intended to indicate somebody or something. He pointed to me. He wants to show me something, that's why. But he pointed at me means he was being, the person was being rude. So students, this was all about the explanation of prepositions. Now it's your time to watch the video again if you have not understood, and try the exercises till 10. Last exercise is on page number 117 in your grammar book only. You need to try the exercise, and then you will be sent the answers also, in which you can easily match up. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.